This follow-up video was prompted by a question from Wally, who asked how we can change this pattern to a cut or a deboss. Thank you for the question. Upon seeing this question, my initial reaction was to go back into the emboss feature and see if we can simply change this to a deboss. Immediately, it became apparent that this is not going to work. Even if we can use a pattern to produce a cut on the surrogate body, the cut remains embedded within the parent body. There is not a lot we can do with this. Let's go back to the finished model of the previous video. An easy way here would be to simply produce an offset of this face. Go to Modify, Offset Face. Select this face. This is basically the face that surrounds the embossed features. Adjust the offset until it exceeds the original emboss. The problem with this method is that it changes the original size of the parent's body. You might want to go back to the beginning of the timeline and create an opposite offset to compensate for this final offset. I will leave that to you to try. What I want to show here is a workflow that does not involve changing the parent's body. Basically, I'm going to create a stamp to cut into the parent's body. Let's return to the finished model from the previous video. Delete the combine, thicken, and surface offset features. Let's hide the surrogate body for the moment. We are going to perform two surface offsets. Activate the Surface tab. Go to Create Offset. Select the face of the parent's body. Set the distance to 0 to create a copy of this face. Let's hide the parent's body to look at this new surface body. Begin the offset command again. This time, select this new surface body and adjust the distance according to how deep you need the deboss features to be. Make sure to adjust the direction of the offset by putting a negative in front. We need this offset surface to be on the inside of the previous offset surface. Let's rename the surfaces. Hide the outer surface. Bring back the surrogate. We shall use the inner surface to trim off the inside portion of the surrogate body. Instead of using the split body command and having to delete that body later, we can use the thicken command. Go to Create, Thicken. Select the inner surface body. Drag the arrow in an outward direction until it fully encompasses the embossed features. Change the operation to intersect. The command calculates the intersecting volume between the thickened surface and the surrogate body and removes everything else. Once you confirm, it also conveniently hides the inner surface body. Let's bring back the parent's body to take a look. You can see that these solid bodies slightly overlap with the parent's body. The amount of overlap is controlled by the offset distance entered during the creation of the inner surface offset. We want to use these solids to cut into the parent body to create the deboss features. If you look at the bodies folder, these are all separate solid bodies. It is obviously not feasible to perform the cut one by one. This is where the outer surface body comes in handy. Let's hide the parent's body and bring back the outer surface. Go to Create, Thicken. Select the outer surface body to thicken. Make sure that you thicken towards the outside of the surface. The thickness does not matter here. Change the operation to Join. With this, all the individual solids would join up with this thickened body into one single body. This will serve as a stamping tool which we will use to cut into the parent's body. Bring back the parent's body. Activate the Solid tab. Go to Modify, Combine. Select the parent as the target body and select the surrogate as the tool body. Set the operation to Cut. With this workflow, the original geometry of the parent is preserved. I'm pretty sure that there are other better ways which I have not thought of. Feel free to leave a comment below.